Marathwada, a region which has always had vision of development in its roots, is positioned in lush greenery, historical monuments, and glorious history. Marathwada saw multiple educational institutions mushrooming at elementary and secondary levels, and the knowledge floated like numerous rivers floating in the region. However, the need of a varsity was long felt. It was in this atmosphere that cross sections of the region's people, the educationalists, politicians, local bodies, citizens, and students demanded for a university. Political leaders like Swami Ramanand Tirth and Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar were in the forefront. The then Chief Minister, Shri Y.B. Chauhan, responded to the demands of the university, and on 5th May 1958, Shri S.R. Dungarkari was appointed as the first Vice Chancellor. The university was named as Marathwada University. Aurangabad, a historical city, was considered the best choice for establishing the university, with its background of the world-famous caves of Ajanta and Ellora. The choice was apt. A towering personality like the Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, inaugurated the university in the presence of Shri Y.B. Chauhan and Shri Prakash on 23rd August 1958. One of the most serene, picturesque area with rich shades of lush green carpets and trees was identified for the university campus. The campus received additional value due to its setting amidst historical monuments, embraced by the Sihachal ranges that conserve the ancient caves of Aurangabad in its bosom from 1st century AD. And the medieval monuments of Suneri Mahal towards the northwest, and Bibi Ka Maqbara, replica of Taj Mahal, towards the east. The university has the most classical and romantic locale. If I were a bird, I would fly over the world and witness the panoramic view of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Marathwada University. We are privileged to view the university from the sky. As you can see, we are flying over the main gate and different departments of the university campus. Set within an area of 725 acres, we can see diverse departments, thousands of trees, lush greenery. We have now reached the first building in the campus that was built. The administrative building was inaugurated by the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Shri Vasantrao Naik, on 4th May 1964. Control, planning, management, and decisions for academic and administrative developments were made in the administrative building with the Vice Chancellor at the helm, Director BCUD, Registrar, Controller of Examination, Finance and Accounts Officer, Management Council, Senate, Academic Council, and other statutory bodies planned for the progress of the university. Here we stand in front of the first ever building constructed on this huge campus, the administrative building of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Marathwada University. It is an honor for all of us to meet this giant personality who has dedicated his life towards education. We are glad to meet Mr. V.M. Pandri Pandey. He started his career as a scientific officer at Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai. He has successfully completed multiple projects under Ministry of Defense and Space Research, DRDO. It's a privilege for all of us to share the views from none other than the Vice Chancellor himself.
This university, named great visionary Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, has a rich academic history of more than five decades. We have initiated the project of Science Park to create interest in the school students toward basic sciences. A big auditorium with electronic facility is under construction, where students will be able to experience audio-visual experiments in the basic science, physical science, as well as life science. We have signed MOUs with many industries in and around Aurangabad region.
Under the administrative control are the various departments of the university that were recently divided into school system. We will visit the first school of six departments, that is, School of Computation and Physical Sciences. The first department is Department of Computer Science and Information Technology with all state-of-the-art facilities. We will talk with Dr. K.V. Kare, the head of the department.
We have developed various research laboratories in the department, specifically under the different project scheme, specifically SAP project stream from DRS space to UGC. We got around 1 crore rupees, where we have developed the multimodal biometric system, remote sensing and GIS laboratory.
The other department of mathematics and statistics are housed in one building. The Library of Mathematics Department is its highlight. Dr. Dhakne, the head of the Mathematics Department. This is the SAP facility developed by Statistics Department, headed by Dr. Bajaj. Let us see what Dr. Bajaj is instructing to his students.
So students, this is the upgrade lab with the four softwares we are having here. So you can see here, we are loaded here, SPSS, this is the latest version, 21 version is the latest one in the market that we updated here. Second is the MATLAB that we have loaded. And third is the SysTab. SysTab is also very important for static students. You can work on that for practical purposes and you can analyze your data.
Department of Physics is one of the leaders in MOUs with foreign universities including California, Australia, Korea and Japan. The details will be procured from the head of the department, Professor Shirsat.
Presently we are running four different specializations in the department: electronics, solid state physics, spectroscopy and nuclear physics. And at present, we are having the grants of more than 2 crore.
Nanotechnology was recently merged in the physics department. Head of nanotechnology department was Dr. Rampal Sharma. Dr. S.P. Zambre, Director, Board of Colleges and University Development, is in charge of affiliated colleges and all research-related work.
University runs 42 departments in its campus and sub-campus, which are divided into 6 schools. In university departments, university has implemented choice-based grading system with grading system since 2011. 3,300 students are obtaining their postgraduate degrees from the university departments from this campus as well as our sub-campus, which is located at Osmanabad.
Department of Chemistry also comes under the SAP DRS and has the highest number of net passed students as well as developed laboratories. Under the second school is the School of Life Sciences. Botany department is a pioneer in leaf protein and aerobiology research in India. We will see its well-developed labs of tissue culture and herbarium. It also has the largest botanical garden in an area of 44 acres. Zoology is the only department with DNA barcoding facility in its Paul Hebert Center with state-of-the-art facilities. We will just see a few rushes of Bhatia in Ratnagiri. The center under SAP, Spatial Assistance Program, is supporting training in scuba diving and PFZ-OSF information through electronic digital display boards. EDDB in coastal region. The zoology department leads in the highest number of MOUs with foreign countries like Israel, Poland, New Zealand, East Africa, and Slovakia, as well as highest number of major research projects.
Where we are hyphenating biodiversity research using the genetic material, which will be a universal technique, and you know, globally people are working with this. We are linked with so many countries, and one global project we are working in this center.
The zoology museum with its stuffed animals is another unique feature of the department. We will talk to Dr. Kilare, the head of the department.
The year 1970, we got a naval project and PL-480 project sponsored by American government. Now send our students to the different European universities around the world.
Environmental Science Department's main highlight is the bird habitat conservation of vanishing birds that is being successfully pursued by Professor Satish Patil. Let's have a bite of Professor Satish Patil.
This is a small attempt what we would like to carry from the department side. In future, definitely we will try to extend this, and we'll see that the wherever we find a barren or the land, uncultivable land, we would like to develop this kind of concept.
Let's have a bite, head of the department, Dr. Murray.
Very proud to say that our university, one of the leading university who has started this subject in the initial stage.
Biochemistry has an exclusive lab in the plant pest interaction. We will learn more from Dr. Kachore.
More than 50 past students of this department working all over the world and in India, most of the research laboratories in India as good scientists. Very proud to say that about 27 of them are working as senior scientists all over the world, and about 30 of them are working as professors and research scientists in various laboratories in the country.
Dr. Mane is the administrative head of the university. Let's have a few words with him.
The university is using its website profusely for communicating with stakeholders through its newsletters, notifications, e-tendering, and publication of circulars. The university has successfully conducted elections with authorities as per the Act, and efforts are made to fill up the vacancies of teaching and non-teaching staff to tone up the academic and administrative atmosphere of the university.
The third school is of social sciences, and history and ancient culture is the first department under it. The uniqueness of this department is the History Museum, the brainchild of Dr. Ramesh Gupte. Dr. Bagare, the head of the department, will talk to us.
We began excavations in Bhokardhan. We also had excavations in Daulatabad. To enrich the faculty and the students, he has launched and built a museum in our campus. Department of History is department which has a large source of artifacts, documents, coins, sculptures, paintings, and many important kind of art objects in our museum.
The economics department is under SAP and also extended its building under the earlier SAP program. The department of sociology is headed by Dr. Mrs. Pratima Pawar. Dr. Wagmare heads the political science department, and Dr. Pratibha Patil, head of the department public administration. The Department of Political Science around 1992 was separated, and another Department of Public Administration was created. The Department of Physical Education caters to the physical development of the university's students. It has a gymnasium and several outdoor activities and is also supported by Sports Authority of India. Department of Education was established in 2006 and its separate building is in progress. It has a well-developed computer lab. Department of Psychology started in the campus in 2007 and its development is in nascent stages. Lifelong Learning and Extension caters to community services and eradication of illiteracy. Hence, holds camps for educated women as well as camps for students' development. Library Sciences and Information Technology has its own library and a well-developed computer lab as well as state-of-the-art classrooms. Geography Department was started in 2009 and is still evolving. Commerce Department is a well-developed department with state-of-the-art classrooms, computer labs and conference halls.
The current Vice Chancellor of Telangana University, Professor Dr. Akbar Ali Khan, is the alumni of the Department of Commerce.
School of Languages. Under this school, the first department is Marathi, one of the oldest departments with Dr. Gimekar as the head. Its unique feature is its possession of Pothishala, 4,000 rare manuscripts in Hindi, Sanskrit, Urdu, Marathi, and Mori from the 16th and 17th century, and utensils of Mahanubhav period. The Pothishala was recently shifted to the Central Library for better preservation. Department of Hindi promotes national language as well as research in Hindi Bhasha and started an interdisciplinary course in media writing. Department of English has a rich language laboratory recently shifted to Central Facility Building and the highest number of foreign students. Dr. Satish Deshpande is the head of the department. Foreign Language Department is an important department, teaching German and Russian languages. Dr. Mrs. Rao is the head of the department. The university took the initiative to start the Department of Urdu in 1999 due to a strong medieval culture in the region, as well as Urdu poetry culture with great poets like Wali and Siraj from Aurangabad. The head of the Department of Urdu is Dr. Ghayasuddin. Sanskrit, Pali and Buddhism too were started in the same year due to the world-famous caves of Ajanta and Ellora in close proximity to Aurangabad and Buddhist literature in Pali. Another important school is of Performing Arts. Fine Arts is an important department where teaching and learning in arts of sculpture and painting is being developed successfully. Dr. Ambedkar, the head of the department, had organized a national workshop successfully. Under the Performing Arts Department, dance, music, and drama are extremely important. Entertainment is an absolute must after continuous teaching and learning for recreation and relaxation. The last school is the School of Professional Studies. Mass Communication and Journalism is an extremely important department that has successfully trained and prepared reporters, editors for local, regional and state-level newspapers and TV channels. Dr. Sudhir Gawane is the head of the department. The highlight of the department is the coming up of Digital Studio. Dr. S.D. Sangre controls the finances of the university where he receives revenue and disseminates to the university officials.
Now this finance and account section is an integral part of administration which deals with all financial aspects. Now, in Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, this finance and account section is headed by FAO, that is a finance and account officer, and he is supported with account officer, two assistant registrars in audit and finance.
The Department of Chemical Technology, most unique for its state-of-the-art equipments, interiors, laboratories, MOUs, and the only department with three patents to its credit. Dr. Vakte is the head of the department. Let's go and meet.
These departments are famous with the nicknames of UDCT. We started the courses of BTech with the AICT approval in the subjects of pharmaceutical technology and food technology.
Department of Tourism Administration is the first and only department in the state of Maharashtra and the first to start the semester system with best facilities of computer lab, seminar hall, and major research projects. The department is well on its way to progress. Dr. Rajesh Ragde is the head of the department. Department of Law is another important department with a high number of foreign students. Its head, Dr. Sadhana Pandey, is associated with district and high court legal service authorities. Printing Technology, a young department in early stages of development, is 100% job-oriented. Management Science Department has excellently developed infrastructure with library, conference room, classroom with LCD and computer labs. Let us have a word with Dr. Sarvaday.
We have some international MOUs. We have MOU with Sri Jayawardene Pro University, Sri Lanka. We have MOU with Thammasat University, Bangkok. We have MOU with the CMI, Chamber of Maratha Industries and Agriculture. We have MOU with the NIPM, National Institute of Personal Management.
It also conducts regular alumni meet. The most important support system for students, teachers, and visitors is the Central Library, with state-of-the-art facilities. It offers the latest facilities and is completely modernized. This library is enriched with high-tech facilities. As soon as we enter this grand structure, we get a feeling of modernized equipments, right from smart digitalized login to e-resources available online for perpetual development. We will talk to Dr. Veer, the librarian, about the library.
Central Library is having 3.65 lakh collections. It consists books, periodical bound volumes, and PhD thesis. Apart from that, the library is having 3 million e-books and 15,000 plus e-journals through variety of databases. It may be of e-journals and e-books. The achievement of this university library is, library has digitized all PhD thesis last during 54 years.
One of the most important service is the examination section that is crucial for students and teachers with facilities like Central Assessment Program, coding, decoding of answer books, strong room, degree certificates. Dr. Ashok Chauhan is the controller of examination and we will talk to him.
The examination section conduct examination twice in a year on the semester basis, and we are bound to declare the result within 45 days with the efforts taken sincerely by the staff members from examination section. We prepare an academic calendar in advance and circulate it to the all affiliated college, which mainly include the tentative program of examination, fee structures, and other details related to the student as well as to the affiliated college administration.
University Auditorium is an aesthetically built building with a capacity of nearly 1,000 audience, with an art gallery, canteen, makeup rooms, parking space, etc. Students and teachers' support system in the university also includes post office, Bank of Maharashtra, 3 canteens, IAS Center, University Science Instrumentation Center, University Network Information Center, hostels, guest houses, gymnasium, etc. Hostels. There are several boys and girls hostels with accommodation and mess facilities for PG, PhD, and postdoctorate students. New hostels for tribal girls is coming up soon. The university has its own construction and renovation department. This department is headed by estate engineer Mr. Kare. The university has the most modernized central facility laboratory, which includes sophisticated analytical instrumentation facility, language laboratory, state-of-the-art seminar hall, etc. The main purpose is to make analytical services available to university researchers and in future also to train faculty and students in advanced instrumentation and conduct and maintain advanced facilities. The university, along with academic and administrative growth, also maintains the environmental growth. It has ornamented several gardens. Besides the botanical garden, the fruit garden, polyhouses, museum, and department gardens are developed. Water bodies are fabricated and water in hostels is heated by solar system for power conservation. Financial assistance to students is given through the Earn and Learn facility, where students work hard to earn and learn. This is one of the most unique features of the university, where students earn through hard labor and learn to be self-reliant. Very recently, a daycare has been started for the university women employees who find it very convenient. Dr. Smita Auchar is its director. Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, besides the main campus, also has a sub-campus at Osmanabad, with the main objective of moving closer to students who could not afford to join higher education at Aurangabad due to distance as well as economical problems. The sub-campus started in the academic year 2004-05. Earlier, it was housed in a government Ayurvedic college. Presently, its building is under construction. The campus has 7 departments, and besides regular departments, has unique departments like water and land management, microbiology, and biotechnology. Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University is marching forward to realize the dreams of its founders to take higher education to every nook and corner and transcend the stigma of backwardness. The tasks ahead are full of challenges, acting as a drag to progress. But the faculty and students stand firm in their resolution to move forward and forward. Even the sky is not the limit, as they want to go beyond the sky and bring total transformation, moral, mental, and material.